we shouldn't forget that the West accepted Pakistan's interpretation of problem in Afghanistan. This was done long time ago, when Taliban revived, 2005, 2006. Pakistan convinced the British government, and British government convinced the American government that the war in Afghanistan is an ethnic war. Do not involve yourself in it. This is why America was confused. The West is confused. They now came up, hopefully, now they have come to their senses. And they should have come now to their senses and realized that this is not a war between Tajik and Pashtun. It's not a war between Uzbek and Hazara. It's a war fought in Afghanistan on the behest of the Pakistan intelligence and army and me. Everybody in Pakistan are pro-Taliban. From the media, from the political establishment, every single political party is pro-Taliban in Pakistan. The army, the establishment, you cannot change that overnight. That mentality was conveyed to the West. And Pakistan had a lot of relationship with the United States and with the British government. So this is why Americans were confused, the British was confused, the West was confused about Afghanistan. They didn't have a strategy, clear strategy. What they're doing, what they were aiming. This is why we wasted a lot of time, we wasted a lot of... Americans left Afghanistan, 14,000 soldiers, or 120,000 soldiers left. They gave all their equipment to Pakistan Army, and they went to America. So this shows the depth of confusion in American, in the Western thinking about Afghanistan. Ghani and others, you know, convinced the West that that is not the case. And especially now, I think that the thinking is evolving in America and the West, that they are coming to their senses and they are seeing things, you know, actual, the reality of the war in Afghanistan and the role of our neighbors, what role they have played. So hopefully in the future, we will have a better understanding, deal with the Taliban, and they start withdrawing. So, and what that, the next step would have been to have this inter-Afghan dialogue. Now, how this plays in reality? How could you have a government delegation is sitting among five other groups and has not the right to say we are talking from the government position, you know, as a group position against a Taliban who has been legitimized and status enhanced as a state of Emirate of Islam Afghanistan. Now, how this Taliban, in that situation scenario, just imagine, in that scenario, how would they would agree to anything less than what they want? They will insist on what they want, and always they emphasize. So I cannot see in that situation any hope for peace. It would have been a prolonged process, it would be a frustrating process, and at the end of the day, there won't be any agreement. Because Pakistan and Taliban, I think they convinced America on a scenario, and they wanted to implement